We are going to discuss cathode ray tube. This cathode ray tube can also be called in the abbreviated form, that is our CRT. So the cathode ray tube, CRT, is a vacuum tube containing an electron gun, which is nothing but the source of electrons, and a fluorescent screen with internal or external means to accelerate and detect the electron beam used to create images in the form of light emitted from the fluorescent screen. So this is a cathode ray tube. Here you will be having some electron guns. You can easily mark that one. These are the electron guns are there. Connectors are there which will be available outside of this cathode ray tube. And using this electron guns, the electron beam will be injected. And this particular electron beam which will be coming through, and then ultimately it will fall on this fluorescent screen. That is a phosphor coated screen is there, and when the electron beam will be hitting on a phosphor atom, then the atom will have the property known as the phosphor is having the property known as a phosphorescence, with the help of which the phosphor atom will be going to the next higher energy level, and it will be staying there for certain duration. Then it will come back to the original initial lower energy level states, and during this transition it will emit some energy, and that will produce the light energy. Okay, the image may represent electrical waveforms, oscilloscope, pictures in the case of televisions, computer monitor, radar targets, and in many other applications. So this is our CRT, where these are the different applications where these CRTs are getting used. So this is a basic construction diagram of one CRT. Now, next one. The electron beam converges onto a point on the phosphor coated face of the CRT screen. For the phosphorescence, the dot glows, but unfortunately this intensity will gradually reduces. This intensity will reduce gradually along with the time. So that's why each and every phosphor must be ignited after a certain rate, and that is actually called the refresh rate, which we have discussed in our earlier videos also. So the time between the removal of excitation and the moment when the phosphor has decayed to 10% of the initial brightness is termed as the persistence of phosphor. So what is the persistence of phosphor? If this question comes, then what will be the answer? The time between the removal of excitation and the moment when the phosphor has decayed to 10% of the initial brightness is known as the persistence of phosphor. So that means the initial energy and the 10% of the energy. So it will be decaying always, because it will go on releasing its energy, which was imparted by this electron beam which struck on them. And this is known as the when it will be reduced to the respective 10% of the energy. So the time will be known as the persistence of phosphor. So again, I'm just explaining this one. So here we are having this electron gun. These are the external connector pins which will be obtained outside of this CRT. And here we are having some focusing system which will focus this electron beam, and horizontal deflection plates which will decide that where this electron beam will be impinging on the inner side of this phosphor coated screen. And here we are having this vertical beam. So vertical beam will decide that in which direction this particular electron beam will be deflected. And here we are having this phosphor coated screen. And here, this is the electron beam we are having. So in a monochrome CRT, there is only one electron gun, but whereas in the colored CRT, there are three electron guns, each containing the display of red, green, and blue light respectively. Unlike the screen of a monochrome CRT, which has a uniform coating of phosphor, the colored CRT has three colored phosphor dots, also known as dot triad. The red, green, and blue at each point on the screen surface. So for the color CRT, we are having a triad, that is a red, green, and blue dots. And when the struck by an electron beam, the red dot emits red light, the green dot emits green light, and the blue dot emits the blue light. So each triad is arranged in a triangular pattern, as are the three electron guns. So three electron guns will be there, dedicated for each color dots, and three colors are there. Both are arranged in a triangular form. The beam deflection arrangement allows all the three beams to get deflected at the same time to form a raster scan pattern on the screen. So in this way, how this cathode ray tube is operating, we are getting this idea. Thanks for watching this video.